Okay, guys, welcome back to another episode of our PGA Tour 15 on the PS4. We're playing the third round of the Arizona Summer Classic. I think we had, what did we finish, 5 under par? Let me check. Yeah, 5 under par. We're sitting 8th. Wind conditions are not too bad, actually. They're not, I wouldn't say it was tricky. First round we played, I think we got to even par, and I think we had a 5 under par for the second round. So, I spent a few minutes trying to set this Elgato, and the sound wasn't recording, and it's not live at the moment. I really think my computer's sort of playing up a little bit. I might have to clean it out. I might have I don't think I've got like a virus, but I think
NBC Golf Channel on EA Sports in association
with my web browser. So I'm just trying to keep an eye and make sure that the sound goes. So here we go. I was actually wanting to do an episode of this and PGA Tour 14 as well, but the two check the leaderboard. So before we get started, we can have a good run at it. That's the I'm a 9 under. Okay. Well, he's yet to tee off, so he's the clubhouse leader. 8, 7. Well, he had a 64. Never heard of his name before. You'll know. I don't know him. Right, let's go. Let's get started here. Oh my goodness. Oh jeez. That's out of bounds. Oh dear. That's not a good way to start. I think the ball's still rolling.
Frank, what's the key? You just hit one OB. Somehow forget what's just happened. Otherwise, the same thing's liable to happen.
I was just about to say that I finished watching the WGC World Golf Championships, the Mexico tournament. Dustin Johnson won in the end by, I think, a stroke. Tommy Fleetwood was 13 under.
Fourth shot wants to get this close. That's not how you picture it, Frank, when you step on that first tee.
No, you'd like to go back to that first tee right now and start again.
Standing over this putt, concentrating on the read.
Frank, how do you explain what we saw here?
It's a mess. It's probably the easiest way to put it. This is a case of anything that could go wrong.
Sound?
Just probably, it did.
I think my sound's back. I don't know if I think the sound cut out there. So whatever I just said, I don't know until I review the video what I said. Oh. I don't know, I've been having a lot of problems with this. Not a lot, but I think my headphones cut out power wise. I don't know what happened there, it seemed as if it cut out. Whoa! Oof.
Not on the fairway here, this could be a tough shot coming up next. Second shot coming out of the rough here.
Right, in the rough. Wind's kinda. Ball's probably just slightly above her feet. 92-95%, it's not that much. 7 foot down, so I'll probably actually just come off it a touch. Yeah, it's moving a little bit more than I thought. Oh dear. Okay, the sound. This sound keeps cutting out. I don't know what is happening. My system at the moment's just, I don't know, it's really strange. Whoa! I don't know my sound. It cut out there. It seems to be like jamming a little bit. I don't know. I mean, it might not be cutting out, but I need to really stop the recording, then test it and make. I don't know. I'll continue on. Get that for part. And I really need a tee, which is not good at the second hole. Into the third hole. Oh, right. How does this one set up? Went behind good.
It's a nice yardage around that 550-560 yard mark. So a good drive, you can certainly reach the par 5.
Ah, that's a better shot. Although I really do need a pee. But I love a pee. Shall we?
Good lie in the fairway, your chance to make something happen here. Frank, even at major championships, a good crowd on a single day might be 25 to 30,000. Consider this for just a moment. At the TPC Scottsdale in 2013, round number 3 on Saturday, almost 180,000 fans jammed into that ballpark. It's hard to imagine twice, that's twice the gate in a Super Bowl on a golf course. Now obviously some of it's hidden because of the size of the acreage, but golf just doesn't get that type of crowds anywhere else in the world. But it works at TPC Scottsdale. They have a crowd that keeps going back. They have the Bird's Nest, for example, that goes there, the parties that ring around there. It's an atmosphere that golf never gets anywhere else, but it really works here. The players feel it too. They breathe it.
Okay, I'm back. I know I probably should have done it before I started recording, but sometimes these things, when you get older in life, you kind of, these body functions tend to kind of surprise appearance on you. Right, where are we? What have we got? 2 foot up. One's slightly behind. It's kind of tricky. Wind coming from the back. What do you want to do? I want to go 177. Oh, that's not a bad hit. Oh, I'll tell you one thing, that was close. Probably that could have been out of bounds. Oh dear, what am I doing?
Setting up here in the rough.
Right, I'm going to put a high lob in here. What have we got? 92, 95, so probably hit it. Probably hit it a bit there. Oh, we're not in the zone at the moment. It's a pretty good chip. Yeah, it could come out of this with a birdie, which is surprising. But I need to keep an eye on this commentary, because I've had commentary cut out before and it's so annoying because there's not much you can do. I've actually spent a whole video talking some quite good stuff, which is quite surprising that coming from me, but it was really constructive sort of talk I was doing, and there was nothing there. It was just an empty video. We have no commentary. So I'll keep an eye on the levels, make sure they're okay. I guess it's back to 4 under. Got a wee bit of wind here. Just going with the wind, though. It's a draw. It's too long. It's way too long.
Slight miss. Some of the heavy grass.
Always difficult coming from the rough because you can get a bit of a flyer, so gonna have to be careful with this. Oh, shit! That's not too bad. Probably gonna be a tricky putt. It's one of those kind of distances where it's
pretty good all day from this distance.
Right, remember the first hole we missed that putt? Was it the first hole or the second? Yeah, maybe just a bit there. Oh, missed that again. Oh, just not getting enough break for those putts. She was still recording, yes. Is that going to be for a bogey? Oh, back to 3 under. Yeah, so Dustin Johnson won the WGC at Mexico. Played pretty well. As I say, John Rahm had a chance. But he made a couple of bogeys, just missed some putts.
Really is. There's nothing like we saw the first 2 days. A series of mistakes just compounding one after the other.
We're struggling at the moment here. It's still early days, we can get this back, but we need to kind of start making some birdies pretty soon. Uphill lie here. Wind's screaming behind, but I don't think it affects the ball as much. Oh, no, I missed that, hooked it. I'm actually going to get away with it, to be honest now. Oh, it wasn't as bad as what I maybe intentionally thought.
Take par yesterday, this one for birdie.
Right. Putt seems consistent from feet to the hole, so 6 inches down, let's accommodate for that. I missed the putt. Yeah.
Very well. Almost made it.
Missed it, mate. A target that just killed it. Might just have breezed by the hole, but. I see, I've just not been playing this game as much. I kind of want to start getting videos, pushing videos out more, but as I say, it's maybe not as easy. We can get over that bunker. Slice it. Maybe should I drew that? It's a bunker. Yeah. Bet you'd be up close against that face. Right, we've got 135 to the pin.
Make sure you focus on the exact spot on the ball you want to hit.
Maybe hit it like 150-ish. Might actually be short. Got one bogey putt. I'm not happy with that shot, to be honest. 2 foot up as well. And it's just. It's almost like. Right on the 2 foot mark, so. Wow, here we go. We're going to be hitting it at least, what, 50, 78? Roughly. See what it does at the top, might break a little bit more. Tom! It's running on a bit.
Looks like you just misread that.
Oh, it's running on a bit.
Getting set now over the
it's one of these putts. Still a bit of break in it. Come on, get in the hole. Oh, just grabs the right edge. And that's good. So I was 10 under. That's the Amos teeing off. I think he's parred the opening hole. Yeah, I think I'm actually going to hit a fade. I'm going to hold it against the wind a little. 206. I don't know whether I want to go 6 iron. Kind of not hit it in the middle of the bot mark. Oh, not playing well. Been a bit scrappy of late. Again, that's all down to not really playing this game as much in the last kind of 2 week period. Maybe go a wee bit extra in this. They had an attitude for a start that was different. For them, it was. Well, put that quite big, but we've hit it bigger. Yeah, it's actually ended up okay. It's probably been short if we'd had it on normal power. Oh, it's a part. I think it's not good enough at the moment. We need to at least get back to 5 under, and then we need to get. Well, Gonzalez has dropped back. Depends what Matsuyama does. I mean, if he gets to somewhat 12 under par, maybe. So we need to get to at least 8, 9 under, I would say. Is this breaking? Kind of does break. I'm going to draw it just a little bit. Not too bad. Just right at target. It's not going to be a bad shot. Very nice it. Sound still recording, I think. Yeah, I don't know about my Elgato. Sometimes it plays up, it just kind of, I don't know. It doesn't pick up the sound and it doesn't pick the mic up. Here we've got 146 into the wind. It's a couple of foot down, so it's not much. Let me maybe just go with this. The wind's going to maybe, that slope's going to bring it back a little bit as well. Maybe just goes just there. Come on, go! Shot. Don't spin too much. That's a half chance we've got. Maybe what, 20 foot, 50 foot? 20 foot. Oh, there's not much breaking this at all. There's a tiny. Tiny amount at my feet, same up at the top there. Right, I think we just go there. Oh, we've had a well shot! No! That probably would have made it if we'd not messed up the power. Not much to this. The only issue would be a lack of concentration or focus. Focus, I need focus on my eyes. I don't know, my eyeballs are not, like, I don't know, I've still been feeling a bit iffy the last few days. My body was sore the other day, my head's kind of still a bit sore with the cold. Yeah, just pretty much straight up here. I'm hitting it in the base, or just. Oh, it's ragged, although that's going to find the fairway. Come on. Chance to set himself up for a good scoring opportunity with his second shot here. Yes, yeah, marginal downhill. Right, I think we need to add just a little bit extra of this wind. Oh, still not hitting that bottom mark. Oh, that's well shot. That is short. Oh, Again, long putts. Oh, we're not in the zone. We're not in it. I'm not even trapped the door to get in it. Oh, I can't really see this putt. It's... yeah, it breaks there. And that's going to be what, say... come on. Kind of, man. I missed it left the target, but just...
sitting right now at 2 over par for the round.
Right, Edward 9. I'm not even going to check my scorecard. I don't really want to be honest. We're 2 over par at the moment. So we're 3 under par for the tournament. We need a big back 9 here. We need a massive back 9, in fact. Right, that wind's quite juicy. Is it even possible? Could we... no, I'm going for it. Oh, I've not only not had it big, I've sliced it as well. It'll hit the road. Now, it's actually not a bad shot, because you don't... you're going to be hitting from the rough, but you're going to have a decent kind of... short iron, short wedge. Are we gonna hit this tree? Right, we don't have a water. We may have to just draw it around this tree, I think. Oh, we just clipped it. Oh, just enough. I just took a tiny bit off it. Just hit a leaf almost. Damn. Oh, we're not making it easy for ourselves. 49 foot. 3 inches up's not a lot. Break. Kind of double. It almost comes back in itself, I think. Hit and hope, I think. I'll come back. Yeah, well. Did come back a little bit, but just when you think you're gonna make better. Story of our lives here. Concentrate on this and at least make par. Could use this putt for par. Oh man, that just made it. Oh man, get me off this course now. Oh god, it's just not going well. This is a wreckage. I think it's going to be okay. I don't finish behind that tree. Oh my goodness. Hopefully we're far enough back where we can actually maybe skirt around it a bit. Now, is that going to hit that tree? See, this is where you can't really see. I think we play it out and we just... well, we're going with the wind as well, so... maybe extra for the rough. Just take that tree out if... oh, at least the spin! Spin! A bit too much on it. No, we didn't hit the tree, but let's try and hold some of this. Maybe just a little bit there. A bit shy, that's perfect. Get it! Maybe should have went a little bit to the left. Right, it's a par. Again, we really need birdies here. And the leaders are not really moving much. That's, I mean, if we... oh god, if we could just get, just start scoring a little bit here. What do you think of the par 312? This is by far tougher, Rich. I'm actually coming down twice here, I think. Bunkering down the left sort of it catches your eye, but it also takes your eye off the water. Oh, still not hitting that bottom mark. I think we're gonna be okay. That could be really good. Just sit down. Sit! Oh, come on. That's a half chance here. Oh, drum roll. Bloody chance coming up. Oh my god. It's one of those putts. I don't know if I prefer it to be like. I don't know. Is it straight? I think it's straight. No, it's not. I've had that putt before. I did the exact same thing. I thought it was straight and there was break in it. It's so annoying. I'd rather have break in it when it's obvious. Oh, that's for having the putt be just good, but then it, to me, it takes away a little bit of the kind of frustration element of it, which I enjoy. Although at the moment I'm kind of not enjoying it, but the wind here is quite tricky. Oh, perfect. Big hit moment. Here we go. Come back. Right, it's maybe going to run out of fairway. It's first cut. Fairway. First cut. Par 5, so, I mean, this is a great chance. 186 to the pin wins. Greens. Right. 186, 7 iron. I think I'm going to take a little bit off it. That wind. Come on! We judge the wind. Oh, baby, go, go! That shot. Oh, we should have left that. We put a bit of loft on it, but maybe we should have left it. But at least we've got a chip. Frank, this is where the mental game really comes into play. You've hit a second consecutive. I think it's going to break a little bit. It's going to initially come across with this lie, so let's go here. And try to make sure this shot certainly gets out. Come on. Come on! Come! No. No. At least we've got a putt here for a birdie. Should be easy. Right, back to 4 under. Right, give the last closing holes. Is that a par 5? Oh, excuse me, that par 5 at the 15th, is it? That's it, then you get a shot par 4. Same over here. A bit slicey. It's going to find the rough. As long as I don't finish behind that tree, it should be okay. Should be okay. Right, where is it? 4 foot up. Wind's in the face. Side hill Y. What's that going to be? Five iron? Maybe a wee bit extra. I've not had it left the target. It's dropped off. Distance was much too long. It's probably too long. That's a bit offline in the rough. Setting up here in the rough. Oh, it's a horrible lie. Oh, I could get a flyer out of here. Oh, had it a bit strong. Right, dropped off, it went to the went to the right, so we're actually going to have a putt left to right back, probably.
Able to manage the distance and now in great position and getting ready for the putt.
Right, we need to get this. Come on, we've got the break right. Come on! Oh, we needed that. I couldn't afford to make a bogey there. Well, Gonzalez is in the clubhouse. He's finished at 10 under. Hey, this is a par 5. Oh, one's in my face. Well, plus 4% power. What is it? 549 to the pin. So what have we got? 300 yards. So we've got 244 to the pin. 247. Actually not a bad shot with that wind. I'm just going to go for this. Oh, we did. But we... Ooh. I don't think we needed to hit it more power. We took that wee bit extra club. Oh, come on! Stop! Stop! Oh man, that's a pretty good shot. Clutch there. Oh, this is huge. This could be absolutely colossal. We can get this in for an eagle. Right, come on. Not much in it. I mean, it's pretty flat here. Oh, there's not a lot in it. I mean, is it straight? I hate these shots. Oh, I've had it. Fight it with power, fight it with power. Oh, come on! We have to target. So maybe had it, we'd have been far away, but I think it was just a touch, a play corner.
See if he can go one better than yesterday when he made par. This putt for birdie.
Well, I guess it's back to 5 under. That eagle would have been huge though, that did, to get to 6 under. Right, we've got the 16th par 3 coming up. And then we've got the short par 4, so we've got a couple of good chances. I'm going to hit this. I don't know if that's going to be... I mean, 1-5. Do we want to go 1-5? 1-5-5? We are a 9-iron. To that wind. Go! Oh! Go! 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 Get out! Oh, so bad. Could only be extra club. Oh, come on. Got a chance here to bump it. Right, this. To me, this is better because now. It looks as if there's just a hint. Yeah, just a little hint, so it's going to be, I think, a bit there. Oh, we've missed it right. Oh, come on! Damn, that was a good chance, actually. We should really should have got that. Now, par's not bad. That should have been a bucket. Maybe there's a bit more break than we thought. Oh, to think we could have been potential, maybe even 6-7 under par at the moment. Maybe I think we just blast this. Ida! Sorry, sometimes I'm going to make that sound when I hit it in a crucial shot. Just. I don't know, it gets my timing right. Oh, bounce, go! Oh, now this should be. I've got a chance here to chip this in. I'm getting a bit dry. I need a drink.
Yeah,
You do have a chance of getting a scent. Let's take a bit of loft. If we just head it straight. Oh, that's it at the bottom. Oh, that just took it away, didn't it? Just pulled it to the left. Yeah. It's guaranteed bogey though. Right. Wow. I guess it's like 7 under? 6 under, sorry. Oh, I missed that, yeah. If we've got that bugged at the last hole, we would have been 7. It depends what Matsuyama does. I mean, if Matsuyama doesn't maybe do much, maybe gets the 11 under, 10 under.
This is a position where a player is absolutely licking his chops here. Good chance to make a birdie.
Yeah, this is when this game just looks like fun. Bunkers don't seem to be in play. The only thing you're really looking at right now is just the flag. This one in, then that's certainly going to help the confidence.
Well, there's an opportunity wasted.
Just knocking him for a par. Let's forget about this one. Golf is not about perfect, but it's going to hurt the course.
Are you kidding me? He just missed that. I cannot believe that. That was such a short putt. So through three rounds, just outside the top 10, what kind of a chance do you give a player who is sitting outside the first 10?
Yeah, it's slim. I certainly would not say none, though, Rich. You know, we've countless times over the years seen someone post an early one in and watch the leaders crumble at the end. Good opportunity tomorrow. Put a good round on the board and then just sit back and wait. And then remember, there's also the chance of a playoff.
Okay. Man, I don't know what's happened here. I think the sound's cut out. I think the sound's back on. This. I don't know what I need to do. I think I need to restart my computer. I don't think it's. I mean, it might be the Elgato, but it might just be the computer's getting a bit glitchy. It's quite an old computer. But the sound cut out there. I don't know how long it was, so now apologize for that. I actually was keeping an eye on it, and I was recording. I need to check back and see what it was. So we're sitting 15th, 5 under par, with 6 shots behind Matsuyama. it's gonna be a big ask, to be honest. But as I say, the sound has cut out. I don't know what's up with this. I don't know whether it's a combination of my computer, my Elgato, or my headphones. I just don't know what's happening. Anyway, guys, that's going to conclude this video. I'll probably upload it tonight. Hopefully, it'll be up sometime tomorrow. And I want to get a PGA 2014 done as well. I need to get to the bottom of this sound problem with this microphone. Oh, God, my throat's so dry. But anyway, guys, I say once again, hit that subscribe button, follow the channel. It's greatly appreciated. We've actually got a couple of subscribers the last couple of days there. It's greatly appreciated, and I'll see you for more sports videos coming up soon. Bye.